Working with illustrators can be tough, but with generative AI tools like Midjourney AI, things are getting better and fun for children's book authors. In this video, I will show you step by step how I created this children's storybook with consistent characters using Midjourney character reference feature, ChatGPT, and CANVA. Let's dive in and see how AI is changing the game for authors in children's literature. In this video, I used ChatGPT Model GPT 3.5, which is free. If you use Model GPT 4, you may achieve better results. However, I think GPT 3.5 is quite adequate for this tutorial. Let's begin with how I generated some captivating ideas for children's stories using ChatGPT. I started by asking ChatGPT, what are the common messages that children's books often convey? Okay, ChatGPT gave me 10 different ideas here, and I decided to try the themes of self-confidence and self-expression. Then I asked, could you please craft a short children's story aimed at kids aged 4 to 6? The story should convey messages of self-confidence and self-expression. The main character is a 6-year-old boy who has a passion for basketball. When I pressed enter, ChatGPT quickly started writing a story for me. It's so fast, it can type a whole story in just a minute. Pretty amazing, right? You can use the script as is, however, I always recommend adding your own ideas to make it unique. At the very least, run a plagiarism check using free online tools. Each story generated by ChatGPT is unique, but it's good to verify. Since plagiarism check is not the focus of this video, I will skip this part. After having the story, we need to create an outline. I like to work on page-by-page basis. This way, you know exactly what happens on each page. It will also help you when you create the artwork later in Midjourney. You will know precisely what should be on every page and which text is already planned. Normally, there should be a minimum of 24 pages, but I made it maximum 10 pages to not extend the video. So, I asked ChatGPT, now let's create a detailed outline of what will be on each page of the children's book. There should be a maximum 10 pages. Then, ChatGPT provided me with an outline of the story. You can read and rewrite some parts if necessary. For instance, in this story, there's a conversation between Alex, the main character, and some older boys. It says, Alex marched up to the group of kids and asked if he could play too. And, sure, why not, one of the older boys finally said with a shrug. Interestingly, this part isn't included in the outline, possibly because I limited the number of pages to a maximum of 10. However, you have options. You can either indicate this to ChatGPT and ask it to add this missing part, or you can personally fill in the gaps while creating the images in Midjourney. In this outline, ChatGPT outlined the concept of illustrations for each page. I thought that if ChatGPT could transform this information into image prompts, my work in Midjourney would become significantly smoother. So, I asked, I want to generate images for each page. Please write me the prompts of each illustration. When I reviewed the prompts, I realized I might not have explained what I wanted clearly. So, on my second attempt, I specifically mentioned DALL-E to help ChatGPT understand better. Since both ChatGPT and DALL-E were developed by OpenAI, I thought I might get a better answer. Even if ChatGPT generated prompts for DALL-E, that would be perfectly fine. It could offer better prompts than what I could create myself, which would work well for Midjourney too. So I asked, I want to generate images in DALL-E for each page. Please write me the image prompts for DALL-E of each illustration. Okay, this time things look better. You can use some parts of these prompts while creating backgrounds or get inspired while writing your own prompts for each page. After that, I focused on creating the illustrations. As I mentioned earlier in the video, I will show you Midjourney's character reference feature to ensure consistent character images of Alex. This feature was announced around a month ago on March 12th. Let's explore how it works. I believe it will soon be available in other AI tools as well. To get started, you will need to sign up for a Discord account. Once you are set up, you can interact with the Midjourney bot on Discord. By the way, to generate images using Midjourney, you will need to subscribe to a plan. Personally, I use the $10 monthly basic plan, which allows around 200 generations per month. If you are new to Midjourney, follow the steps on the quick start page of the Midjourney website to join the Midjourney server on Discord. Firstly, I needed to create our main character Alex. That was the prompt I was using. So I added all details about Alex, and I wanted him in pixar style. By the way, I think when creating the characters, a white background works better. --AI parameter changes the aspect ratio of the generated image. You can change it according to your needs. And those were the characters that Midjourney generated. I really liked the look of the top right character. It had a red crew neck t-shirt, gray melange joggers, and white shoes. So I decided to use that one and upscaled it. Okay, if you want to change some aspects of your character, you can do so by using the Wear Region tool. This tool becomes available after a Midjourney image has been upscaled. Click on the Wear Region button to open the editing interface. You can then choose either the freehand or rectangular selection tools to select the areas of your image that you want to regenerate. Afterward, click the Submit button to send your request to the Midjourney bot. However, I didn't want to regenerate any part of this image since all the details looked fine. Then, I used Midjourney's character reference feature to create images of this character in different situations that ChatGPT had already described for each page. Firstly, let me explain how to write prompts to apply this feature. As you can see, to add character reference to a prompt, we use the --cref parameter with the image URL. To get the image URL, you can drag the image directly into the prompt box, or you can click the image, right-click, and select Copy Link. Okay, now let me show you how I tried the image prompt that ChatGPT offered for the first page. As I said, you can use some parts of these prompts while creating backgrounds, or get inspired while writing your own prompts for each page. So, the ChatGPT's image prompt was this one for the first page. And this was the prompt that I wrote. I think including the description of your character inside these prompts as well gives better results, even though you are using character references. That's why I took the idea from ChatGPT's prompt, included my original prompt, and added the href parameter. And I also added the --cw character weight parameter here to set the strength of the characterization. --cw accept values from 0 to 100. --cw 0 focuses on the character space only. Higher values include the character space, hair, and clothing. The default is --cw 100, but I added it anyway. And this was the result I got. I liked the left button one and upscaled it. Actually, it looked quite good except for the basketball shoes. As you may have noticed our reference image, the basketball shoes of Alex has red stripes, and this one has black stripes. There's a way to fix it. I simply cut out the shoes from the original character image, and then re-uploaded them into Midjourney. Next, I created a character reference link specifically for the shoes. Then, I went into the Wear region for this image. I describe it as white mid-top basketball shoes. For the character reference link, I passed it in the link I created for the character's shoes and then select the shoes as closely as possible. As you can see, the shoes had changed, and the results were really good. The first version had more red color, but this one looked fantastic, so I upscaled it. Okay. Then, I attempted the second image prompt that ChatGPT had provided for the second page. ChatGPT's image prompt was this. And this was the prompt that I wrote. I incorporated some elements from ChatGPT's prompt, included my original prompt, and added the href and cw parameters. Okay, I liked the fourth image, so I upscaled it. As you can see, it was nearly perfect. The only issue was the number of fingers. Again, I used the Wear Region editor and selected the finger areas in the image. Then I wrote Show All Fingers and submitted the changes. Here were the results from my first attempts. As you can observe, the results weren't ideal, so I decided to regenerate the same prompt. This time the first image looked better with 5 fingers. And I also upscaled it. Here is the picture of the second page. I think it's quite good. What do you think? In this manner, I generated images for all the pages based on the outline provided by ChatGPT. The next step involved creating the interior pages of a short children's storybook by using these images in Canva. I opened a document with a page size of 8.625 by 11.25 inches, which includes bleed margins for 8.5 by 11 size. Then, I uploaded all the images generated in Midjourney for this story. Following that, I began by dragging the first image onto the first page and positioning it accordingly. Next, I clicked on the Element tab and selected the rounded square from the Shapes menu. I changed its color to white and positioned it at the bottom of the page. Then, I adjusted the transparency slightly by dragging it down a bit. Afterward, I clicked on the text button and added a subheading. passing the text recommended by ChatGPT for the first page. I changed the color to black and moved the text box onto the rounded square. You can change the size and type of the font to get the best look for the page. Finally, I combined all the images with text recommended by ChatGPT for each page, completing the interior pages. After that, I created a cover file and named the story The Little Hoop Star as ChatGPT recommended. I created a flipbook using the simple booklet flip app in Canva. I have a dedicated video on my channel that explains how to create flipbooks in Canva. You can watch it later. So I skipped this part to avoid wasting your time. Here is the final version of Alex's story. In addition to creating flipbooks for your stories, you can also make videos, like the one shown here. However, this could be the topic of another video. If you are interested in learning how to do it, please write in the comment section. I hope this video was helpful for creating children's storybooks with consistent characters using Midjourney's character reference feature. If you found it helpful, please consider subscribing and liking the video to support the channel. Thanks for watching. See you soon.